Championship Wrestling. The AWA presents the greatest stars in professional wrestling, bringing you the best in mat action. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN. I'm Larry Nelson, and before we do anything else today, I'm going to talk about the Cash Dollar family of Cleveland, Ohio. We got postcards from Donald and Robin and Terry, and we have named them our co-fans of the weeks from the AWA here. Donald, Robin, and Terry Cash Dollar from Cleveland, Ohio. If you want to be considered as fan of the week, there it is. That's where you send your card or your letter, and we will definitely give you consideration. Great, exciting news coming up today. Stanley Blackburn made a decision involving a match between the Midnight Rockers and the Midnight Express for the Heavyweight Tag Team Championships. We'll have more about that a little bit later on. A big surprise. Stay tuned. Plus all kinds of exciting wrestling. Right now, let's go to the ring with Mick Karch.
Okay, fans, here we go with a tag team bout on AWA Wrestling. In the ring at 230 pounds, out of Memphis, Tennessee, he is Van Horn. His tag team partner at 220 pounds out of Nashville, Tennessee, Jake the Milkman Milliman. And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents. First of all, at 265 pounds from Vancouver, British Columbia, the man who claims to be Canada's greatest athlete, he is Slick Nick Kaniski. And his tag team partner at 288 pounds out of Oakland, California, Mr. Magnificent Kevin Kelly. They are accompanied to the ring by their manager, Medusa Michelli. One ball down the ringside.
The lovely Medusa Michelli managing this tag team combination of Nick Kaniski and Mr. Magnificent as they get set to take on Van Horn and Jake the Milkman Milliman. And of course it is the combination of Kaniski and Mr. Magnificent with a great, great weight advantage of 553 pounds combined weight. We're talking now to 450, the combination of Van Horn and Milliman. Ray the Crippler Stevens, you've seen Kaniski and Mr. Magnificent in action individually and collectively. How do you assess these two?
Well, I tell you what, both of them are tremendous wrestlers. Both of them are very tough men. Both of them are in excellent condition. So that speaks for itself right there. Kevin Kelly is extremely strong. Nick Kaniski has a tremendous background of amateur wrestling and professional wrestling. His father, a former world heavyweight champion, so he comes from a wrestling family. Now Jake Milliman is a good little wrestler, but he's going to be overpowered here by weight and strength, I think.
It is Jake the Milkman Milliman and Mr. Magnificent. Jake has some rather unconventional moves at times, but he indeed is colorful. Tags in Van Horn. Kevin Kelly, Mr. Magnificent, won the Tough Man contest on more than one occasion. That consists of three rounds of boxing. It's a two-day tournament, and in one of them, which he won, it consisted of 36 entrants, and all areas of competition were dominated by Mr. Magnificent. Now Nick Kaniski in, doing a number on Van Horn, and really a powerful body slam by this 6'3", 255-pound giant out of Vancouver, British Columbia, self-proclaimed as Canada's greatest athlete as he has the neck of Van Horn draped over that top rope.
They're taking it right to him. They're being very offensive, Van Horn.
There's a double elbow. Kaniski being chased out by Bob Warren after he's tagged in. Mr. Magnificent, who goes to work on the eyes of Van Van Horn. Van Van Horn is out of Memphis, Tennessee. Weighs 230 pounds, and Jake the Milkman starts in after to help his partner, is chased by Bob Warren. And over on the other side, it's Kaniski, as you see there, clubbing away from outside of the ring.
Well, I'll tell you what, they're a powerful team, and they're a good team. They're capable of beating anybody at any time. And they've been together for some time now. They have the experience as a team.
A forearm and a clothesline, all wrapped up in one by Mr. Magnificent on Van Van Horn. And now, a tag in of Nick Kaniski, who doesn't do a lot of work in the gymnasium lifting weights. His conditioning exercise is a 3 to 5 mile run every day. And there is the pile driver. And it's all over for Van Van Horn. Nick Kaniski and Mr. Magnificent, Kevin Kelly, and their manager.
The pile driver was done with excellence.
Ah, yes. Medusa Michele, dressed up in another very, very colorful outfit, as the combination of Kaniski and Kelly. They want to add a few more lumps to the likes of Van Van Horn and Jake Milliman. And a little shake there by Medusa Michele, the ladies AWA champion. Let's look again here at this pile driver. Ow. That's all. That's all. For Van Van Horn. And another W here for Kaniski and Kelly. From the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Vegas, for Ray the Crippler Stevens, I'm Rod Trongard. We'll be back in a moment.
Michael? Mike?
Hello.
Jays. Michael Jordan cologne. Oh, that's soft.
Who wants some? Who wants
some? Oh, not the tongue!
Cuba.
Oh!
What's happening, Mike?
The Comfort Soft undershirt. There's soft, then there's Comfort Soft. Only from Hanes.
Can you sign this for my mama?
Wouldn't it be nice if everything in life came with a worry-free guarantee?
You, get in there.
Well, at Rent-A-Center, everything does. With our worry-free guarantee, we'll match any competitor's price on brand-new, brand-name merchandise. No credit hassles, delivery, setup, and service included. And you gotta love it or your money back. Rent-A-Center. We make it easy to make it your own.
The Kansas Jayhawks are national champions. Celebrate with Sports Illustrated's exclusive championship package featuring this must-have official championship DVD. Plus, this special hardcover commemorative book captures the five-time champion's incredible season and tournament run through SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIorder.com or call now to get both free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save 64% off the cover price. Use your credit card and you'll also get this collectible Kansas Jayhawks National Championship basketball. It's designed exclusively for SI in celebration of the nation's number one team and includes a display stand. Go to SIorder.com or call now to get the official championship DVD, the SI commemorative book, and the collectible basketball.
Go online to SIorder.com or call 800-351-1100 right now.
Hello again, everyone, from the Showboat Sports Pavilion. We're at Las Vegas, Nevada, and it's a pleasure to be joined again by Donna, who has more information on more people and the Samoan, Destroyer Samoan, coming on strong at the very, very outset as he explodes on Rice and also Steve-O. But it looks like he's going to pay a price, and oh, does he ever, Donna.
I think he asked for a bit more than he could handle, and he's regretting what he did there.
As Steve-O now tags in Ricky Rice,
Well, Rod, I think... Whoa! These two should be a solid combination. They each come from an impressive amateur background in wrestling, football, and hockey.
And you're talking about Rice and Steve Olsinowski.
As you can see, they've got a lot of pride, a lot of confidence going into the ring as they easily handled the Samoan from the start.
Samoan coming back, however, and Steve-O is paying the price as both Stamp and the Samoan work over Steve Olsinowski in their corner on their side of town, the wrong side of the tracks as far as Steve-O is concerned.
Well, Steve had the option to play either baseball professionally or football. Like I said, they both came from a real good amateur background. As they...
Crunch time. Oh, and a hard right hand by Stamp. Followed by a judo shot by Dennis Stamp, who hails from Amarillo, Texas. And Steve-O has a problem going for him right now. But he comes out of it beautifully.
That's what you call putting their heads together on that one, Rod.
No two ways about it. A drop kick here by Steve-O.
Impressive aerial drop kick.
And Stamp goes reeling, and here is Rice. A hard body slam by the young man out of Edina, a 232-pounder who is a real up-and-comer.
Whoa.
And a suplex by Ricky Rice.
Just take a look at this young wrestler. Almost had him. He was a state AAU champion while attending the University of Minnesota Duluth. And you'll notice his powerful legs, Rod. He played hockey throughout high school and played on a junior hockey league. And professional teams wanted him, such as Chicago Blackhawks, could have a pin, Washington Capitals, and L.A. Kings.
A good-looking young man indeed. And teamed up with a veteran, Steve Olsinowski. They indeed can complement each other extremely well. Stamp trying to back off to the Samoan, and then Olsinowski goes over and bangs away and may have hurt that right hand. Stamp following up from behind. And suddenly it is the Samoan entering the ring. Scott Ledoux trying to chase him. Apparently there was a tag. Here's a whip on Steve-O, and oh, what a shot to the face by, he is called the Destroyer Samoan at 310 pounds, and now works the frontal lobe of Steve Olsinowski, who has taken a bit of a pounding over the past couple of minutes, and here's a running clothesline. The Samoan goes for a, well, whether
headbutt.
That would be a pile driver with his own headbutt, a diving headbutt by the Samoan that Olsinowski rolled away from, and he rolls off and makes the tag to Rice, and now the Samoan tags in Dennis Stamp.
I've noticed a lot of Samoans and just previously who we saw Tanaka, they use their heads a lot. And I don't know if that's cracking coconuts or what, but they have a strong head.
Well, it's the style of the Samoans that you will see so many of them, if not all of them, use.
Beautiful.
And there's a monkey flip by Ricky Rice on Dennis Stamp on a front face lock. Rice follows up quickly, then moves and tags in Steve Olsinowski. The AWA, the Major League of Professional Wrestling, and Stamp is feeling the effects of both Olsinowski and Rice. He is able to kick his way out as Steve-O tried to put him away there, and here's a whip again by Steve-O, and a big backdrop.
Well, Ricky really appreciates the crowd when they cheer. He said it really fires him up and helps him in his time of trouble. Beautiful drop. That's one of his favorite moves, that flying drop kick, as you'll see Steve's maybe in this match. Wow, look how high he gets, Rod. Incredible.
Indeed. And that second one was more devastating than the first. And here is a flying crossbody, and this one is all over. It was trouble indeed for the combination of Destroyer Samoan and Dennis Stamp. And great work by those two, Steve-O and Ricky Rice, and he loves it. Everybody loves it here from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Well, they were certainly impressive, and perhaps their amateur background helps.
And there you see in slow-mo the big backdrop by Steve-O, which sent Stamp on his way, and Steve-O then tags in Ricky Rice, who came on to deliver a couple of devastating drop kicks. The second one caught Stamp flush in the face, and this one was all over, and all over in favor of the combo of Rice and Olsonowski. There's the first whip. And here comes Stamp, and he's going to get the first of two drop kicks. That one caught him in the chest. And the next one was right on the button, and it was all over. For Donna, I'm Rod Trongard. We're at the Showboat in Las Vegas, Nevada.
Enjoy a world of freedom with IndulgiBath. Getting into your tub has never been easier. The comfortable built-in seat ensures complete safety. The hydrotherapy jets are therapeutic, and the adjustable shower head can be used while sitting or standing. IndulgiBath gives you more great features for your money, and there's a worry-free warranty. You could receive a $750 cash rebate. Call now for your free information pack. IndulgiBath, the world's best walk-in tubs, made in the USA.
ESPN Classic is celebrating the second annual Tribeca ESPN Sports Film Festival with a week of critically acclaimed films. Every night at 8, we discover past Tribeca Festival highlights with films that capture the passion, teamwork, and competition of sports.
And the Chiefs have taken the lead.
Get focused as Classic goes theatrical with the Tribeca ESPN Sports Film Festival tribute all this week with an all-day marathon on Saturday, only on ESPN Classic.
Championship Boxing, Thursdays at 8 Eastern on ESPN Classic.
Dream big.
All drivers to your cars.
Drive fast. And never look back. From the creators of the Matrix trilogy, let your imagination race.
Speed Racer is unstoppable.
Speed Racer.
See you at the finish line.
Rated PG in theaters and IMAX May 9th.
Introducing the all-new Dodge Journey with the most innovative features, third row seating, DVD player and gaming outlet, 5-star crash test rating, and the best fuel economy in its class. It's the crossover that's ready for anything, the all-new Dodge Journey. If you can dream it, do it.
All right, fans, the action continues with a one-fall match. In the ring from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, at 250 pounds, he is Tom Rocky Stone. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, at 290 pounds, out of Tempe, Arizona, one of the strongest men in professional wrestling, if you will, it's Billy Jack Strong. One fall bout, down to ringside. That man, Billy Jack Strong, out of Tempe, Arizona. That's where he headquarters nowadays. Former great football player at the University of Wisconsin for John Jardine. How'd you like to have that man line up as your nose tackle defensively and try to run through or around him, one or the other?
I'll tell you, he looked like he could walk right through a cement block wall, doesn't he?
And Rocky Stone is finding out exactly how strong he is right now, and Stone doesn't like it. World-class power lifter is this man who is motioning Rocky Stone to come at him. A smile across the face of Billy Jack Strong. Benches over 600 pounds, squats over 900, deadlifts over 600. Hey, world class indeed, Billy Jack Strong.
If I'm not mistaken, did Wahoo McDaniels find this?
I believe he did. I believe he did. And Rocky Stone is finding out some things about Billy Jack Strong right now. Go ahead, Ray.
I tell you what, he is super impressive. You can tell this man is strong. He's got the right name, Strong. Oh, look at that.
He just about catapulted Rocky Stone, not only out of the ring, but maybe out of the Showboat Sports Pavilion and out of the entertainment capital of the world itself. Wow, what a shot! Stone comes up with a knee to the solar plexus and clubbing blows to the back, three of them, and it doesn't look like they really phase Billy Jack Strong. Stone trying to pick him up, and Strong reverses on him and just about puts him through the canvas.
This guy is a powerhouse, I'll guarantee you.
Look at that. Great close-up work here from the showboat again by the great camera crew headed by Dan Ormsby in all of the direction in the truck from Al DeRusha and Polish Joe. Looks like Strong took a shot somewhere and is in rather a precarious situation, at least for the time being, but resilient as he is, I don't think it'll last for long. But running the eyes across that top rope doesn't help at all, Ray Stevens.
Well, I tell you what, Stone's got the right idea, but he better stay on the man. He can't let up. If you let up on a guy that's strung well right now, you can see he's just making him mad.
Indeed he is. Stone bounces his head off that turnbuckle three times, and Billy Jack Strong goes to work on Rocky Stone.
Oh!
Picks him up and lets him down. What fantastic biceps and what a torso on this man, Billy Jack Strong. And a shoulder block that stops Rocky Stone dead in his tracks, sends him backwards, flat on his back. His eyes are shut. He is out of it. Billy Jack Strong picks him up to add a little bit more punishment to it and just pounds him on that canvas. Picks him up one more time. Off to the corner. Rocky Stone doesn't know if he is on foot or horseback. There is no two ways about it. And Billy Jack Strong wails away on him. And here he comes with a front pile driver. Stone rolling over on his back. Billy Jack Strong isn't through yet. Uh-oh. The pile driver, it's coming again. Oh! Stone doesn't move. And you can see why. And he is indeed that, Billy Jack Strong, out of Tempe, Arizona, and the University of Wisconsin. Puts away another one in very, very convincing fashion here from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas as there he goes and looks back one more time at Tom Rocky Stone, who is there laying in the ring being attended to by referee Marty Miller, rolls over on his face and trying to get to his feet as hopefully we get another look at how Billy Jack Strong put the finishing touches here on that front pile driver coming from the second rope, and it followed an all series of maneuvers, including pile drivers and you name it. And Billy Jack Strong has done it again.
Here at the phone company, you've been our customer for a long time. Now Vonage wants to change all that.
Well, over 2 million people have already switched to Vonage.
Oh, really? Don't they miss having phone service?
Actually, with Vonage, you get the number one rated digital phone service with unlimited local and long distance calls, all for just $24.99 a month.
Unlimited for $24.99 a month?
Sure. With Vonage, you can make all the phone calls you want for about a dollar a day. What do you charge?
It's simple, really. It starts with different basic rates, long-distance fees, and of course, different packages have different features, and some actually, I got some charts back in my office. So I could
Vonage has over 25 features, and they're included for no extra charge.
All this for only $24.99 a month?
One low rate with savings up to $300 a year. Can your phone service do that? Don't take my word for it. Listen to his former customers.
For me, Vonage is everything I want in a phone service.
It's dependable. It's perfect.
No nickels and dimes like the phone company.
No hidden fees. No sticker shock when you get your bill each month.
I have no complaints. I'm like, woohoo!
Okay, so Vonage has great service at a great price, but making a change is hard. And for over 100 years, the only thing we've changed is...
Your prices?
Sign up now with Vonage and get 1 month free. Enjoy clear digital phone sound quality using your high-speed internet connection. And setting up Vonage is easy. Or if you don't have time, we can come to your house and do it for you. And with Vonage, you get to keep your number for life.
At Vonage, you'll always talk to a real person, no matter when you call. But what happens if you try to reach those guys after hours?
You have reached us after business hours. But your call is very important to us.
Please call back.
Goodbye.
Call 1-800-866-0798. That's 1-800-866-0798. Or go online to betterwaytophone.com.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Let's go get them.
Tighten your belts up. Ready? All right, man, here we go.
Pace cars off.
2-1, green flag.
The NASCAR Nationwide Series at Richmond on ESPN2. Classic racing action. Coverage begins Friday at 7 Eastern.
Tomorrow on ESPN Classic at 8, from high school to the NBA. Through the Fire, the story of point guard Sebastian Telfair on the Tribeca ESPN Sports Film Festival tribute. And at 10, the original American Gladiators. It's all tomorrow on ESPN Classic.
Everyone, for Pro Wrestling Illustrated magazine, this is senior editor Bill Apter with another special AWA press conference. Today, the experienced veteran Wahoo McDaniel. Wahoo, welcome to press conference.
Good to be here.
Okay, first of all, Wahoo, I want to ask you this. You had said in a recent edition when you wrestled Curt Hennig in several strap matches that it was more important for you to beat him in an Indian strap match than to actually win the title from him. Could you explain that?
Well, you know, I won a $1 million battle royal and got my dream match in Vegas, which was a strap match. During the strap match, somehow the strap got cut. Curt Hennig got 50-some stitches in his finger, and I ended up winning the strap match, but not in the way that I wanted to, because, you know, I'd like to think that I am king of the strap matches. Strap matches are the thing that I do best, and usually when you have a strap match, you can settle your problem, because a man can only run 8 feet. And he's got to stay there and fight you. And I don't think any man in wrestling today, if he stands there long enough with me 8 feet away, is going to last too long with me.
Okay, now there's a manager here in the AWA, Paul E. Dangerously, who has been a real thorn in your side for quite some time. You've been around wrestling for quite some time, Wahoo, and seen a lot of managers. Sum up what you think of this Paul E. Dangerously.
Well, you know, he's a mouthpiece for the
Midnight Express.
Right. Evidently, they can't talk very well, but they're good wrestlers. They're the world's champions, or they wouldn't be where they are. He does all their talking for them. He's a thorn in the side, and when you wrestle, it's like 3 against 2.5 against 2, and it makes it very hard. The man, no doubt, is an intelligent individual. He travels all over the world. He does all their talking for him. You see him everywhere. He does all their contract signing, and most of the time, everything comes out in their favor. So, you know, you can't say he's a dummy because he's not. He's an intelligent individual. He gets on TV and he tells you how it is, and he's done a very good job as far as the management. I don't think without him, they would be where they are today.
Okay, they are AWA world champions. Wahoo McDaniel's had several partners trying to get those belts from the Midnight Express. You haven't succeeded yet. You're training Billy Jack Strong at this time, a new rookie to the AWA. Do you think this man might be groomed to be your perfect tag team partner?
Well, you know, Billy Jack Strong is an Indian boy. He's of Indian descent. He's from Tempe, Arizona. He's like myself. He's an ex-football player. He's 290 pounds. He's strong. He could probably lift this building if he wanted to. He's coming along very fast. The people like him. I like him. And believe me, when he's in there, you can turn your back and he's going to be right there beside you.
Do you think he'll be ready, though, as a tag team partner for you to win the belts?
Let me tell you something. After when I go to train him, I train him right. And you know I can name a list of a lot of guys I've trained, including Ric Flair, down the line, a lot of guys that I've trained. They've all done fairly well. I'm not saying I'm the greatest trainer in the world, but I'm saying this guy has got a lot to work with. And if he'll listen to me, who knows? We may be the new world champions, Indians.
Thank you, Wahoo. For Pro Wrestling Illustrated, this is senior editor Bill Apter. We'll see you at the matches.
Are you one of the millions of people who think you just can't learn a new language? The problem isn't that you can't learn, it's that you've been using the wrong method. Well, thanks to our breakthrough software called Rosetta Stone, learning a new language is now incredibly easy and a whole lot faster.
I've probably learned more in the first 2 weeks than I have in months of taking formal classes.
Unlike traditional methods that require hours of tedious translation and memorization, with Rosetta Stone, you're actively engaged in each lesson. From the very beginning, you'll see real-life images and hear native speakers.
El caballo corre.
This powerful combination teaches you to think in a new language, not memorize, so speaking comes naturally. You'll learn far more easily and more quickly.
I've used a lot of different mediums, the books, the tapes, and it just, bar none, it's the best one that I've ever used.
I was one of those people who thought they could not learn a language, and I needed to learn a language for my job, so I needed to learn Spanish. And I learned Spanish quickly, and I did it through Rosetta Stone.
Rosetta Stone is so fast and effective, it's used by the U.S. State Department, NASA, the U.S. Army, and Fortune 500 companies, and is the world's leading language learning software.
It's almost like having your own person there teaching you, your own private tutor who is just very relaxed in your home with you, sitting there teaching you the language.
Rosetta Stone is the fastest way to learn a new language. And to prove it, we'll send you our amazing demo CD, absolutely free when you call. There's no obligation to buy. Right away, you'll see for yourself just how fast and easy it is to learn a new language with Rosetta Stone.
This really is a great program.
I believe that you can learn any language with this program.
If you're serious about learning a language, there's no easier way to do it than with Rosetta Stone.
Call the number on your screen now and see for yourself why Rosetta Stone is the fastest way to learn a language, guaranteed.
Here we go, fans, with more AWA action coming to the ring from Amarillo, Texas. At 242 pounds, he is Dennis Stamp. And ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the ring from the Soviet Union, at 305 pounds, he is Soldat Ustinov. One fall, down to ringside. Soldat Ustinov showing off the hammer and sickle, the flag of the Soviet Union. Soldat, big and strong. And using that word again, strong, Billy Jack Strong, who we have watched just a few moments ago, and for about the fifth or sixth time, I don't know, Ray the Crippler Stevens, that I have ever seen anyone as strong as Billy Jack Strong.
You probably won't in football or anywhere else in the world in wrestling. He looks like one of the strongest men in the world to me.
Soldat Ustinov is big and strong in his own right, and screams away in a very guttural type tone at the crowd here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion as Dennis Stamp ducks under and gets a hammerlock on the big man out of the Soviet Union, who fights right back with an elbow smash, and now a hard body slam. Dennis Stamp out of Texas takes an elbow smash, and here's a quick cover by Soldat Ustinov, who grabs him by the hair and picks him up where he could have pinned him right here at the almost outset of this match.
He just got a mean streak in him, Rod, or he would have pinned Dennis then. First guy, I don't know, don't sell Dennis Stamp short. He's a one heck of a wrestler.
He's 242 pounds, certainly big and strong enough, 6'2" out of Amarillo, Texas. His eyes are glassy, however, as you got a chance to see there.
Yes.
After that whip across the ring, and here comes Soldat. Oh! Stamp gets out of the way, and Soldat may have collided with the top of that ring post. I don't know if he did. It would seem that his forehead would be split wide open. It does not seem to be the case as he takes a backdrop from Dennis Stamp.
I'll tell you what, when you take a backdrop the size that he is, that's going to take a lot of the air out of it.
And that stopped Stamp cold. That big size 17 boot of Soldat Ustinov just too much, as he caught Stamp coming in with a rush and caught him flush. And look at that expression.
That shows you what I know. I just said that took all the air out of him, and he came right back and beat the man.
He doesn't like it. Well, we don't know what that man's opinion is of that particular man who wins another one here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. Back he goes as we will look at the way this one comes to an end. And there you see the backdrop of Stamp, and it looked like Soldaud may have been stunned, and there's the whip, and here comes the boot right in the face, caught him right on the chin as he came in. Soldaud with a quick cover and a three count and victory here from the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas. For Ray the Crippler Stevens, I'm Rod Trongarden. We're going to be right back.
Hi, we'd like two fudge brownie temptations.
Mom, just make it one.
I'm surprised you wanted to share.
Actually, I don't.
Pardon me, ladies. This is compliments of the gentleman in the donkey shirt.
It's like shooting fish in a barrel.
Fall in love with the new fudge brownie temptation at Dairy Queen. Topped with gooey fudge, moist brownie pieces, and whipped topping.
So he's going away with Avis. Again. He'll probably get the where to GPS so he can find all his precious fancy coffees and driving ranges on his business trip. Fine. That's the way he wants it? Fine. Forget about him. You don't need him. Did he just look back? I think he looked back.
Where to GPS can find anything from a driving range to a latte. Just one more reason Avis is your other car.
The Kansas Jayhawks are national champions. Celebrate with Sports Illustrated's exclusive championship package featuring this must-have official championship DVD. Plus, this special hardcover commemorative book captures the five-time champions' incredible season and tournament run through SI's famous writing and photography. Go to SIorder.com or call now to get both free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated. 56 issues for only $1.59 an issue. Save 64% off the cover price. Use your credit card and you'll also get this collectible Kansas Jayhawks National Championship basketball. It's designed exclusively for SI in celebration of the nation's number one team and includes a display stand. Go to SIorder.com or call now to get the official championship DVD, the SI commemorative book, and the collectible basketball.
Go online to SIorder.com or call 800-351-1100 right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, you just heard us talking about where the AWA will be in action in your area. I can't wait for Minneapolis, Minnesota. With all those superstars coming back for the autograph session and the cameras will be out, you can get your pictures taken with the old-timers that made the AWA famous, the Minneapolis Auditorium. That's on February the 4th. We've got a match coming up here that just plain, I find it historic. Two teams with the Midnight in their name, the Midnight Rockers and the original Midnight Express, meeting in Las Vegas with the tag team championships of the world on the line. The former champions, the Rockers, back in Nevada after being suspended, taking on the current champions, the Express, bound and determined to hang on to their titles, convinced that they can hold off the former champion Midnight Rockers. A serious battle ensues, and I mean exciting, exhilarating, a great wrestling match. Let's go back to Las Vegas, the Rockers against the Express.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening.
You wanted big time? You want big time? I'll give you big time. Paulie Dangerously gets to you, the tag team champions of the world. Loverboy Dennis, Ravishing Randy, the only team that rock and rolls past midnight, the Midnight Express.
Combined weight of 475 pounds, Shawn Michaels
here we are at the moment of truth. It's midnight against midnight. The Rockers against the Express. The former tag team champions against the tag team champions. It is for the championship of the world as the Midnight Rockers, Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels, attempt to take the championship belts from the Midnight Express, Ravishing Randy Rose, Loverboy Dennis Condrey, and their manager, Paul E. Dangerously, as we on ESPN, the Total Sports Network, from coast to coast and continent to continent, from Seattle to San Juan, from San Francisco to San Salvador, from Houston to Honolulu, from London to Los Angeles, from Miami to Maui, and New York to New Zealand. Everybody is looking in. I'm Rod Trongard, along with Mick Karch. And Mick, this is one that you and I and the world has been waiting for ever since the Midnight Rockers came back to the AWA.
I do not remember a more long-awaited match by literally every wrestling fan all over the world, Rod. And I'll tell you something, I know we're supposed to be unbiased here at the broadcast table, but that man that was just on camera, Paul E. Dangerously, I would like nothing better than to see him crying in his beer at the end of this one.
Judy Moore, who is the manager here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion, is also at ringside. And if maybe if we can get a look at Judy Moore, we haven't seen her in a long time. As we say, she is here at ringside. And there she is, lovely Judy Moore, as she is ready to watch with the rest of the world this tag team championship match between the Midnight Express and the Midnight Rockers. Mick, hello there.
Yes.
Do you feel that in any way that either one of these teams are favored in this match?
I would have to say, Rod, based on past history, you'd have to say the Midnight Rockers should be favored. We've seen them in action recently. Their teamwork is precision. They haven't lost a thing since the last time we saw them. And quite frankly, I think the Midnight Express, their days are numbered. It could end right here tonight.
I would agree with you, except for one fact, and you mentioned it earlier.
No.
Paul E. Dangerously, and how dangerous he is outside of that ring in one way, shape, or form or another. And he may be the difference, the determining factor in this one.
We can only hope that the referee keeps a close eye on that man.
It is Condrey, and it is Shawn Michaels. And the crowd wants Michaels to drill him, and drill him he does. Six times to the forehead. And one more for good measure. And out he goes.
Mr. Dangerously tried to go over him, lend a little assistance to his man. He saw the Midnight Rockers approaching, and he bailed out real quick.
Condrey outside of the ring is now being picked up by Marty Jannetty.
Oh.
As you look at it there, and maybe you felt the concussion of that. We did here, as we're only about 10 feet away, and it is Jannetty again, now on Ravishing Randy Rose, right in front of us, and Rose hits the deck.
Those two are going to eat supper standing up for a week.
How about breakfast and lunch?
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Every arena that we have been in, Rod, for the past several months, the fans have asked, when are the Midnight Rockers coming back? When are they going to get a chance at the Tag Team Championship? Tonight could be the charm.
There's only one thing more I would like to have seen happen in that sequence. That Paul Dangerously would have been the third to feel the effects of the atomic drop.
What a
Marty Jannetty. Maybe it'll happen. Maybe it'll happen yet.
Would you say that Mr. Dangerously is not exactly the favorite here tonight of this crowd?
I think that you may have just made the understatement of the year.
Look at this. He's got a man to plug his ears for him, too. Wait a minute.
What's happening? And now Marty Jannetty and Shawn Michaels go over and grab the championship belt and start putting them on their waist. And all of a sudden, the Midnight Express has second thoughts about what they were doing. What they were doing being walking back to their dressing room.
I never saw Mr. Dangerously turn around so fast in my life.
one of the few times he has changed his mind.
Rod, we can't take anything away from the champions, though. We've extolled the virtues of the Rockers.
Oh, man. Marty Jannetty coming racing from post to post with a running clothesline on Dennis Condrey.
As I was saying, like him or not, the Midnight Express has been known to pull out every trick in the book that's necessary to hang on to those championship belts.
Conference time. On both sides, we might add. Because while you saw Condrey and Rose conferring, so were the Midnight Rockers. It's the Rockers against the Express for the Tag Team Championship of the World, a close-up of Marty Jannetty. We're at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada. I'm Rod Trongard, along with Mitt Karch, and that is Paul E. Dangerously. And he doesn't want the cameraman on him. Reversal here. Condrey. Uh-oh! The Express tried to do the same thing that the Rockers did a bit ago, but it backfired on them. And Dennis Condrey is the one who paid the price. Rose was the one that came charging across and caught his tag team partner with a clothesline.
I'm no clothes horse, Rod, but does Paul E. Dangerously own another jacket besides that one?
Just out of curiosity. I don't know. We'll have to ask him sometime.
You asked him.
All right. Again, conference time for the champions. Hookup, Marty Jannetty. Ravishing Randy Rose. Oh, how Jannetty and Shawn Michaels want that championship belt back again. Look at that!
Oh, beautiful.
Wow, what a move by Marty Jannetty. And follows it up with a couple of hip tosses on Randy Rose, and he wants timeout. Sorry, wrong sport, Randy.
He is absolutely fluid motion in that ring. I'm talking about Marty Jannetty. He makes everything look so effortless. What a consummate professional.
Indeed. I think they do have that over the Midnight Express.
Whoa.
Hello there. And now, Paul E. Dangerously on the apron, as you see, as out goes Shawn Michaels. And also out there, as you see him, is Dennis Condrey with a backbreaker on Shawn Michaels. Marty Jannetty on the other side being restrained by referee Marty Miller. And again, it is Condrey after Shawn Michaels. And he rams him into the ring.
He caught that ring apron right in the lower back. Oh, you could feel that from here.
And now Rose going to bring him back in with a suplex. They come crashing to the canvas. And Shawn Michaels has got to be hurting.
He's in trouble.
And hurting bad. A two count for the tag team champions, the Midnight Express. Don't go away, ladies and gentlemen. All kinds of fireworks can be expected to break loose in this one. And there is a clothesline which catches Shawn Michaels again. Rose rolls him over, covers him, and gets a two count.
You talk about courage and desire. These Midnight Rockers are something else again. That clothesline just about took Shawn Michaels' head off, cartwheeled him in midair, and he still beat the three count.
The Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas, Nevada is rocking for the Rockers. Condrey, again another backbreaker. Here is a cover.
Oh, that's incredible. Absolutely incredible intestinal fortitude being shown by Shawn Michaels. His back has to be absolutely crippled up by now.
Condrey cupping those hands under the chin. And there is Marty Jannetty looking, shouting encouragement to Shawn Michaels. Oh, what battles and what wars we have seen them in here at the Showboat, particularly here at the Showboat Sports Pavilion in Las Vegas. Shawn Michaels had Condre up, but then Condre pops him on the head. And now takes him back to the corner where the knee of Ravishing Randy Rose awaits.
I pointed it out before, Rod. This is the mark of a championship team. Cut off the ring, preventing Shawn Michaels from making the tag to Marty Jannetty, who is just chomping at the bit to get in there.
A two count for Rose and the Midnight Express. The great resiliency, the great conditioning of Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty. That hand better not go down again, or this one is all over.
He's fighting it.
Oh, is he fighting it? Fighting it indeed. Rose hanging on. Shawn Michaels fighting back, and a hard shoulder block. Michaels again. Oh, and he is cartwheeled by the knee of Randy Rose as Michaels waited too long. Should have gone over instead and tagged in Marty Jannetty. But, you know, the shoulda, hadda, gotta, you can carry it only so far. And, hey, they're the ones that are doing it inside of the ring. We're on the outside looking in and watching. And it's so easy for us to make those decisions and very, very difficult for the men on the inside. Shawn Michaels again fires away.
Oh, he's got to make that tag.
I'm Dennis Condre.
Got to make that tag.
Condre makes a tag, and back in comes Ravishing Randy Rose. And he immediately assumes the assault on Shawn Michaels. Here he comes. Is it over? Not quite. Marty Jannetty came over and grabbed a hold of the hair of Randy Rose just when it looked like the Midnight Express was about to put the finishing touches on this one.
This time it was Jannetty who made the save. Shawn Michaels has taken some punishment for the past several minutes.
Look at that knee. You saw a good profile shot of that knee in the middle of the neck, or in the lower part of the neck of Shawn Michaels. Rose putting tons of pressure on both front and back. Michaels grabbing a hold of the hair, bringing himself back up. Shawn digs to the body, digs again and again. And a drop toe hold here by Rose, and in comes Condre. Well, certainly the Midnight Express has the advantage at this point. Abdominal stretch by Condre.
I don't know if our cameras picked him up, but dangerously, look at again, this man is jumping up on the ring apron.
And he's got that telephone in his hand, and I'm so, look, here's Rose. Across the back of Shawn Michaels, and that back has taken a tremendous amount of punishment here in this match.
Oh.
Two and nine tenths. It doesn't, it can't get any closer.
No way.
Front face lock, tag in Condre. Condre marking the spot, and
that's
bombs away.
That is just insult to injury to do something like that. Do not take this too lightly, Mr. Condre.
The referee separating Condre and Jannetty, and Rose takes the opportunity to really hammer Shawn Michaels. Oh, Michaels has taken a ton of punishment. Jannetty is going to have to get in there sooner or later, or this thing is going to come to an end in short order. There was a karate shot to the throat of Shawn Michaels. Across he goes. He ducks underneath. And he comes over and makes a wild dive.
He's got to get up.
But he has spent all of his energy as he put both Condre and Rose on the canvas. And Marty Jannetty can't get to him. Shawn Michaels trying to get to Jannetty. Here he is. And here's the man out of Columbus, Georgia, Marty Jannetty, on both Condre and Rose. It's Jannetty with a pile, with a body slam, another body slam. And Jannetty now grabs a hold of the two of the Midnight Express and
bang.
Says, hey, have you met each other lately? Marty Jannetty having to go it alone now, as Shawn Michaels went it alone for some time. Small package, and a count of two. Now Shawn Michaels is back on his feet, and he comes after Rose. Jannetty has a front face lock on Dennis Condrae. The referee, Marty Miller, counting. And there may be a double disqualification here. And if that indeed is the case, well, the belts stay with the champions. But of course, Jannetty and Shawn Michaels know that very well. Snap suplex. Oh. Marty Miller, the referee, went down as he may have dislocated a knee or popped an ankle. He is absolutely in no way able to continue refereeing this match. He is on hands and knees. He really struggling to get to his feet. Comes over. He has the count going. And
wait a minute now. The ring of the bell rung.
Bob Warren has come in. Bob Warren has come in, and I don't know who has won the match. Is it the Midnight Walkers? It is.
That's the way it looks right now. All right.
Total pandemonium.
...240 miles above the Earth when IMAX needed to power their camera. They trusted Duracell. And if you think advanced technology is only for outer space, consider this. Down here, now you can take up to 5,000 pictures over the life of two batteries. Duracell rechargeables. Recharge in just 15 minutes. They're rechargeables reinvented. So whether it's some amazing shots today, or you're gazing a little further into the future, it just has to work. Duracell. Trusted everywhere.
ESPN Classic is celebrating the second annual Tribeca ESPN Sports Film Festival with a week of critically acclaimed films. Every night at 8, rediscover past Tribeca Festival highlights with films that capture the passion, teamwork, and competition of sports.
And the Chiefs have taken the lead.
Get focused as Classic goes theatrical with the Tribeca ESPN Sports Film Festival tribute all this week with an all-day marathon on Saturday, only on ESPN Classic.
Championship Boxing, Thursdays at 8 Eastern on ESPN Classic.
Do you have a crushing tax debt? Raquel A. did and saved $215,000 after hiring Tax Incorporated. So did Mark D., who saved $62,000 in IRS debt. If you owe the IRS or state more than $10,000, Tax Incorporated has helped thousands stop IRS collections and settle their tax debt fast. Our attorneys will fight to remove levies, eliminate penalties, settle payroll tax, file tax returns, lift liens, and get you a fresh start. Like Brad B., Tax Incorporated filed his tax returns and saved him $239,000. Or Terry M., who avoided an IRS bank seizure and saved almost $100,000 in payroll taxes. If you owe more than $10,000 in tax debt, call our legal team for help. The 2008 tax relief deadline is fast approaching. Submit your settlement before it's too late. Tyson H. did and saved $1.4 million after hiring Tax Incorporated. Call us today.
Wrestling action, ladies and gentlemen, of course, was the big news of the tag team champions of the world. The Midnight Rockers back, beating the Midnight Express at the Showboat in Las Vegas and recapturing the tag team championship belts. The Midnight Rockers over the Midnight Express. What more can I say? We have tag team champions that we can be very, very proud of in the Midnight Rockers. Fans all over the country delighted at this news. We saw Sold Out Ustinov, the big Russian, in action today. You got a good long look at this big, big, rough Indian, Billy Jack Strong. Of course, Slick Nick Kaniski and Mr. Magnificent looking great in tag team action. And we got a lot more of that coming up for you next week here on AWA Championship Wrestling. Again, I want to salute my first time ever three combined winners of the Fan of the Week. And they are Donald and Robin and Terry Cash Dollar of Cleveland, Ohio. And I want to thank those fine people for sending us the postcards. There, ladies and gentlemen, that's where you can send your card or your letter if you want to be considered as our Fan of the Week here at the AWA. And don't forget, right here, same place, ESPN next week, we will have the original wrestling league, the Major League of Professional Wrestling, the AWA, on ESPN week after week. And I want you to join me. Again, I want to congratulate my buddies, the Midnight Rockers, recapturing the tag team championships of the world. You join us next week.
in the ESPN tape library. The worldwide leader in classic sports launched a series designed to take a new look at old games. They called it Cheap Seats with Ron Parker. Parker, an anchor with attitude, was helped thanklessly by tape librarians Randy and Jason. The show was slated to go all the way. But moments into the first show, tragedy struck. With Ron on the DL, somebody needed to step up, like Gehrig for Pip or Brady for Bledsoe. Sitting 2 and 3 on the hosting depth chart, that someone was Randy and Jason. That is their story. And this is Cheap Seats without Ron Parker.
Hey, Randy and Jason here on Cheap Seats, and today we're going to be visiting with an old friend, ABC's Wide World of Sports. Now, Wide World was sort of like a melting pot for all these sports that couldn't make it on their own. And these ragtag events banded together to form a mighty whole.
Not unlike the band Menudo.
And today we're going to be looking at 3 of these events.
It's what to look for. It's what to look for.
Now, as you watch today, you're going to want to look out for the Wide World announcers in each event. You will be able to gauge how well a Wide World announcer's career is going by looking at the event he is sent to cover.
If he's in sunny Acapulco for cliff diving, things are going well.
If they send him to a sweaty gymnasium in Petaluma for the wrist wrestling championships,